So very good morning to all of you and welcome back once again to the session of PIB 247. Main hu Manish Mishra and in today's session guys I will bring to you some more questions from the PIB news which are relevant for the ESI section of RBI Grade B and above. So let's begin with the session and wo jo National Asset Monetization Plan launch hua tha that has already been covered by Neha ma'am and Tanvi ma'am so I will not repeat that. बस मैं उसमें आपको एक बात बताना चाहूंगा कि किसी की बातों में मत आना, सरकार ने कुछ बेचा नहीं है. एसेट को मोनेटाइज करना अलग होता है और बेचना अलग होता है, ठीक है. देयर इज अ डिफरेंस बिटवीन सेलिंग आउट द एसेट एंड मोनेटाइजिंग द एसेट. आई होप आपको जो वो कॉन्सेप्ट है वो क्लियर है. एंड प्लीज डोंट गेट इन टू वर्ड्स ऑफ एनी अदर पर्सन हु इज सेइंग दैट द गवर्नमेंट इज सेलिंग आउट एवरीथिंग. ऐसा कुछ नहीं है, बहुत अच्छा प्लान है, इससे गवर्नमेंट को फायदा ही होगा. एंड ऑफकोर्स गवर्नमेंट को फायदा का मतलब होता है सिटीजन्स को फायदा होगा. ऑलराइट, so let's begin with the session, but before we begin, if you are coming here for the first time, do subscribe to the channel and press this bell icon. You can also join this telegram group and here you will find the PDF of this session and iska link you will find in the description. So let's talk about the very first question which says the Ministry of Power issued energy saving certificates to the industrial units because they saved more energy than the targets. How these units are benefited through these certificates? So these energy saving certificates guys are given to those industrial units which have saved more energy than the targets assigned to them. ठीक है, और उनको क्या दिया जाता है? Energy saving certificates. And it has been given by Ministry of Power, which is of course is headed by Mr. R.K. Singh. And R.K. Singh's Lok Sabha constituency we all know is in Ara, which is in Bihar. And he is also the Minister of New and Renewable Energy. So let's talk about this news. The Ministry of Power has issued more than 57 lakh energy saving certificate to 349 industrial units because they have saved more energy than the targets that they have that they were assigned. And remember this, these energy saving certificates are given under a scheme which is known as Perform, Achieve and Trade, which in short is PAT scheme. Perform, Achieve and Trade. This scheme guys remember was launched by Ministry of Power in the year 2012. Okay, and of course iska jo fayda hoga in industrial units ko wo ye hoga that they can sell these certificates to those units which have not completed their targets. Ye kya kar sakte hain, ye apne certificates ko un units ko bech sakte hain jinhone apna target complete nahi kiya hai, wahan se inki kamai ho sakti hai. Okay, now talking about PAT scheme more, so PAT basically guys it is a market based compliance mechanism that aims to accelerate improvements in the energy efficiency throughout all the industrial units. Jitne bhi industrial units hai wahan pe energy efficiency ko badhane ke liye this scheme was launched in the year 2012 by Ministry of Power and it is less a scheme and more a compliance mechanism. All right, also the nodal agency for this is Bureau of Energy Efficiency and this compliance mechanism is being implemented under the National Mission for Enhanced Energy Efficiency. National Mission for Enhanced Energy Efficiency ke under isko implement kiya ja raha hai. All right. And these are some of the key features of the scheme which is known as PAT. Like for example, the scheme seeks to enhance the cost effectiveness through certification of excess energy savings in the energy intensive areas or the sectors. Then under the scheme an energy audit is also done because aisa bhi ho sakta hai that industrial units are manipulating their data of energy saving, so for that there is a provision of energy audit also so that they cannot manipulate their data related to energy saving. Okay, so these are some of the key features. Now let's come back to the question. Question was how these units are benefited through these certificates. And of course I hope you all remember that 2022 the target for renewable energy is 175 gigawatt and by the year 2030 it is 450 gigawatt. So these units can sell these certificates to those units that could not achieve their targets. Yes, this should be the correct answer. These units get some tax reimbursement. Okay, so option A is the correct answer guys to this question. I hope this question is clear. And now let's move ahead to question number, and of course yes, this is very important. Units which are not able to meet the targets either through their own actions or through the buying of the certificates. Agar koi aisa unit hai jo ki certificate khareed bhi nahi raha aur usne apne actions ki madad se targets ko achieve bhi nahi kiya hai, then that unit shall be liable for a financial penalty under the Energy Conservation Act of 2001. Energy Conservation Act है 2001 का, उसके अंडर financial penalty लग जाएगी ऐसे units पे जिनका target achieve नहीं हुआ है either through their own actions or through buying the energy saving certificates. All right. Now let's talk about question number 2, which is about the Zycov D. Which of the following is not correct with regard to the newly launched COVID vaccine, newly approved, in fact, you can say COVID vaccine Zycov D. So let's talk about this Zycov D. So we all know Zydus Cadila, which is a Ahmedabad-based company, has launched this new vaccine, Zycov D. And remember, this is world's first DNA-based vaccine. It is world's first DNA-based vaccine. And of course, it has been developed indigenously. So it is world's first and indigenously developed DNA-based vaccine for COVID-19, and it will be administered in both adults and children. Adult ke liye bhi hai aur children ke liye, dono ke liye hai. Talking more about this, so it has been developed in partnership with the Department of Biotechnology under the Mission COVID Suraksha. Mission COVID Suraksha, which is being implemented by BIRAT. All right. And this is a 3-dose vaccine and the 6th vaccine that has get approval from the DCGI, Drugs Controller General of India. And who is the Drugs Controller General of India? It's Dr. V.G. Somani. Dr. V.G. Somani is the Drugs Controller General of India. And also, the very important thing about this vaccine that it is a needle-less vaccine. So, needle-less vaccine mein jet injector type ka ek डिवाइस होता है, उसका इस्तेमाल होता है, जिसको बोलते हैं हम जेट इंजेक्टर में क्या होता है, देयर इज नो नीडल, इस तरीके का जैसे लाइक देयर इज अ सिलेंड्रिकल थिंग एंड देन द टिप इज लाइक दिस, द सर्कुलर टिप, ओके, और यहाँ पे एक प्रेशर डालने के लिए होता है. अब इसके अंदर इतना हाई प्रेशर होता है कि ये जो लिक्विड है इसके अंदर, दिस हैज टू मच प्रेशर, ये जो लिक्विड है ये स्किन के पोर्स के थ्रू एंटर कर जाता है. Okay, so this is known as the jet injector. So there is no need of needle in it. So now let's come back to the question, guys. We have to identify the not correct statement. Okay, it is the world's first DNA-based vaccine. Yes, this is absolutely correct, and it has been indigenously developed. It is India's indigenously developed vaccine. Yes, it is for the child 12 years and above. No, it is for the both children and adult. No needle is used for administration. Yes, this is also correct. Okay. So the correct answer should be 1, 3 and 4, but this is not in the option. It is for the child 12 years and above. Okay, yes. Yes, guys, yahan pe ek baat yaad rakhna. Ye jo vaccine hai, ye children or adult dono ke liye, but those children who are 12 years and above. So this statement I think is correct. Okay, let me check it once. It is the world's first DNA-based vaccine. It is in this, ye theek hai. ठीक है, नो नीडल इज यूज फॉर एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन. यस, सो ऑल द स्टेटमेंट्स आर करेक्ट बिकॉज दिस इज फॉर दोज चिल्ड्रन हु आर 12 इयर्स, जिनकी एज 12 साल से ज्यादा है. सो ऑल आर करेक्ट शुड बी द करेक्ट आंसर, ऑप्शन ई वुड बी द करेक्ट आंसर. एंड नाउ लेट्स टॉक अबाउट क्वेश्चन नंबर 3. एनटीपीसी लिमिटेड हैज कमीशन द लार्जेस्ट फ्लोटिंग सोलर पीवी प्रोजेक्ट ऑन द रिजर्वर ऑफ सिमाद्री थर्मल स्टेशन विच इज इन विशाखापट्टनम में है. एंड विशाखापट्टनम इज द 18th रेलवे जोन ऑफ इंडिया, जो कि लास्ट रेलवे जोन बना है हमारे देश में विशाखापट्टनम में. एंड विशाखापट्टनम ऑफ कोर्स इज इन आंध्र प्रदेश. विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग इज नॉट करेक्ट अबाउट दिस प्रोजेक्ट सिमाद्री थर्मल स्टेशन विच इज द लार्जेस्ट फ्लोटिंग सोलर पीवी प्रोजेक्ट. लेट्स टॉक अबाउट दिस प्रोजेक्ट देन. रिमेंबर दिस, the capacity of this project, guys, is 25 megawatt and it has been commissioned on the reservoir of Simhadri thermal station, which is in Visakhapatnam, which of course in Andhra Pradesh. All right, and this, remember, is also the very first solar project to be set up under the flexibilization scheme of the Ministry of Power. Now what is this scheme, flexibilization scheme? Under this scheme, all the thermal power stations are being converted to the renewable power plants. Okay, मतलब ऐसे power plants जहां पे renewable energy का use होगा, which shall replace thermal power with the renewable energy. Now moving ahead, these are some of the features of this project. Like, it is spread over the 75 acres. It has the potential to generate electricity from more than 1 lakh solar PV modules. This would not only help to light around 7,000 households, but also ensure removal of at least 46,000 ton of carbon dioxide from the environment. So these are some of the basic facts about this project. You can read from the PDF. And now let's come back to the question. The capacity of electricity generation of this solar PV project is 110 megawatt. No, it is only 25 megawatt. So this statement is incorrect. 25 megawatt hai iska. So not correct nikalna hai. So first statement is the correct answer, option A, because this is the incorrect statement about this project. Question number 4 pe chalte hain. What is the objective of the portal Yukt Dhara launched by the Ministry of Rural Development? Now who is the Minister of Rural Development? It's Giriraj Singh. Yeah, it's Giriraj Singh. And Giriraj Singh's Lok Sabha constituency is Begusarai, as we all know. Question is regarding the objective of the portal Yukt Dhara. Ek Yukt Dhara naya portal launch hua hai. So let's talk about this portal then. Remember guys, it is a new geospatial planning portal. Geospatial planning portal, jiska naam hai Yukt Dhara. And this project, this portal has been launched in collaboration with ISRO. ISRO or Ministry of Rural Development ka isme collaboration hai. Alright, so Yukt Dhara hai, and remember Yukt Dhara is a portal under the Bhuvan portal. Bhuvan portal ke andar hi ek separate portal ek aur add hua hai, Yukt Dhara. Now what is the purpose of this? So remember, it will facilitate planning of new Manrega assets. Jo Manrega assets honge unko geotagging ki jayegi aur unki detail dali jayegi is portal pe. So all the Manrega assets will be geotagged and their details will be uploaded on this portal, jiska naam hai Yukt Dhara. And not only Manrega assets, all other schemes of rural development will be covered under this. Like for example, per drop more crop. If there is an asset under per drop more crop, then that will also be covered. If there is an asset under watershed management, then that will also cover. Okay? And if there is any asset under the PM Kusum, then that will also be covered. So basically all the assets will be geotagged and their details will be uploaded on this portal, jiska naam hai Yukt Dhara. Alright, so as I told you, it will serve as a repository of assets created under various national rural development program like Manrega, integrated watershed management, per drop more crop, etc. And it is a joint effort of ISRO and Ministry of Rural Development. And who is the chairperson of ISRO? It's Mr. K. Sivan. And now let's come back to the question. Question is what? Okay, regarding the objective, to provide houses, no, to serve as a repository of assets created under various national rural development programs. Option B is the correct answer, guys, to this question. And moving ahead to question number 5, which is the last question for today. Which ministry has launched the Samriddh program? Samriddh program, batana hai ki kaun si ministry ne launch kiya hai. Let me tell you the answer first. It has been launched by Ministry of Electronics and IT. Ministry of Electronics and IT, which is headed by Mr. Ashwini Vaishnav. Theek hai? And Ashwini Vaishnav is also the Minister of Railways. Is also the Minister of Railways and also the Communication. And he is a Rajya Sabha MP from Odisha. So the correct answer to this question is Ministry of Electronics and IT. But what is this program? Let's talk about this. Remember, there is a full form. Startup Accelerators of MITI for Product Innovation, Development and Growth. This is the full form of Samriddh, and this has been launched for providing a conducive platform to Indian software product startups. Jo hamare desh ke software se related startups hain, unko conducive environment provide karane ke liye this scheme, this program has been launched. And under this program, various type of support will be provided, like financial support provided, mentorship will also be provided. And this has been launched. This will be implemented by MITI Startup Hub. There is a Startup Hub of Ministry of Electronics and IT that will implement this particular scheme. Now, what are the types of support that will be provided? So, an investment of rupees up to 40 lakh to the startup based on current valuation and growth stage of the startup will be provided. Alright. And there is the scheme has a focus on accelerating the 300 startups by providing customer connect, investor connect, etc. And also it will facilitate equal matching investment by the investor. Okay, so यही है समृद्ध प्रोग्राम में। समृद्ध प्रोग्राम बेसिकली गाइस इज फॉर प्रमोटिंग, इज फॉर प्रोवाइडिंग सपोर्ट टू द स्टार्टअप्स बेसिकली एंड दो स्टार्टअप्स व्हिच आर इन द सॉफ्टवेयर एरिया। सो मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स एंड आईटी इज द करेक्ट आंसर। ऑलराइट, सो दैट्स इट फॉर द सेशन गाइस। आई होप ऑल द क्वेश्चंस आर क्लियर। इफ यू हैव एनी डाउट्स यू कैन आस्क मी इन द कमेंट सेक्शन। थैंक यू सो मच फॉर वॉचिंग। गुड बाय, टेक केयर एंड गॉड ब्लेस।